Anybody remember that tune?
No.
Don't listen to your radios, do you? Boy, I wouldn't listen to that rock and roll. It's up to the devil, let me tell you. I can play country songs, I can play bluegrass, I can do rap or crap, whatever you want to call it. Every bit of that can be of the devil. Amen? Mm-hmm. But the whole thing, let me give you some backdrop for a little bit of foundations. So this song has got a very tragic story. Gin Blossoms was the name of the group, and the guitarist, Doug Hopkins, was the guy who wrote Hey, Jealousy. Now, it was about his old girlfriend, who obviously he was wanting to get back with again. And he said, if I hadn't blown it all those years ago, I might be here with you. You know, and so the idea here is he's feeling the sense of loss. He's heartbroken. He's miserable. And he's jealous. The song dates all the way back to the 1980s, late 1980s, when the band included it on their album. And the album was called Dustin. Have you ever played a game and got dusted? Or have you played a game and dusted somebody? You see where I'm going with this? It's kind of negative, isn't it? The whole album was, I mean, are you with me? The idea though is that when they released this album, it was released to an almost unknown record label. And so for a couple of years, you know, they really didn't gain any popularity. They had some, my understanding was they had some following in Phoenix, Arizona, but it didn't go any farther until one day there was a representative from A&M Records found them. And he heard the song, Hey Jealousy. And he signed them up. Now, they started going through these recording sessions and they're doing a new album. Are you ready for the title? Right? What's this? The New Miserable Experience. How many want to go out and just buy a copy right now? The New Miserable Experience. And again, you know, it included some of the song, new versions of the song from the album, Dusted. But here's the thing. After they received this contract and they started doing these recording sessions, the problem was that this young man, I call him young, he was about 30 years old or so, Doug Hopkins, because he had turned to drinking, it's actually in the lines of the song, I'll promise not to drink. He turned to drinking. He was miserable. He was heartbroken. He was trying to drown his sorrows. But he became very unreliable. You didn't know if he was going to show up. And when he showed up, you didn't know what kind of condition he was going to be in. You didn't know what, or you kind of got to expect the unexpected kind of a thing. And it wasn't anything that they desired. And so what happens is that they fired him after the recording was done. Cut him loose. Now for the next couple of years, the band began to rise to stardom. And here you see Doug Hopkins lost his girlfriend, lost his place in the band. From a distance, he's watching as the band he was part of is being elevated, and they're you know they broke through with this recording, and now it's making a hit. So he got even more depressed, went a little bit deeper in sorrow, till in the summer of 1993, Doug Hopkins, at the age of 32. Commits suicide. Now the band continues to play, or continued to play that song, and they consider it to be a tribute to young Hopkins. Now you might say, so what does that song have to do with John McMillan's worship song, How He Loves? Well, John McMillan's song is also about jealousy. Amen? But this kind of jealousy is of a different kind. It's a jealousy of, you could say, of the divine type of jealousy. The opening lines of the song, How He Loves, I mean, you look at what we see here, you know, oh, I mean, he is, what, jealous for me. He's jealous for me. Loves like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. Now, think about the weight of the wind. What is the wind? What is it used as an example in the Bible? What is that? What is the wind? It's the Holy Spirit. The presence, the very presence of God. The presence of the living God, the Spirit of Jesus, that's right here with us. And the mercy, can you imagine? Maybe you're not quite understanding this. Maybe you're not really comprehending the amount of mercy that we're receiving rather than judgment. You see, jealousy, it's not really a word that's typically used in association with an understanding of God. It tends to be a word that is got a negative rap.
Yes.
Jealousy often makes us think of envy. Jealousy makes us think of people behaving badly, as with the story behind hate jealousy. So what is jealousy? In what sense can we say that God is jealous? Well, jealousy is a pretty strong, it's a very intense emotion. I mean, show of hands of anybody who's never been jealous of anything. Oh, okay. How many of you have been jealous? How many of you are jealous? Wait, what's one of the Ten Commandments? Thou shalt not. That could be envy. That could be jealous. That could be, are you getting what I'm saying? There's a reason for that. We'll be covering that in subsequent messages. But this jealousy is a very intense emotion.
Yeah.
Now, we might call jealousy a passion. We might even refer to it as zeal, or even another one, fury. Jealousy, how is it triggered? Well, jealousy is triggered when your rights or your honor is affronted. If we believe that something belongs rightfully to us, but is then given to somebody else, we will instinctively feel jealous. Well, that wasn't supposed to be mine. For example, a husband and wife may feel jealous if their partner in marriage has been unfaithful in any way. Normally, you know, because most of us have that kind of a deranged mind, we want to jump to the worst thing. But did you know there's other ways of being unfaithful, amen, than committing the deed, as it were? But by its very definition, watch this, marriage is an exclusive, say exclusive. What is the root of exclusive? Exclude. So it's an exclusive relationship. The vows between a man and a woman, the two shall become
one,
or exclusive. Amen? Forsaking all others. Amen? Remaining faithful. How long? Till death do you part. Somebody say, okay.
Amen.
Now, there are some things in marriage that just should not be shared with anybody else. Both husband and wife have every right to expect faithfulness and loyalty from their partners. So, a jealous reaction, a feeling of intense fury or passion in the context of unfaithfulness in marriage, it's fair. You might even say it's understandable. Amen? In fact, the more you love your husband or your wife, the greater the potential for jealousy. I mean, am I preaching good yet?
Amen.
But not all jealousy is fair. Not all jealousy is right. Some jealousy is misplaced. For example, if you